Hard disk recording is everywhere, from professional studios to live recordings on a stage, on tour with your laptop, and now due to more sophisticated and affordable equipment, even in home recording. Some tips, tricks, and basic information in this video. The output of a microphone is an analog audio signal, which is ideal for recording onto mediums such as magnetic tape. But in order for us to record onto a hard disk, we have to convert this analog signal into a digital signal. The two main characteristics of the digital signal are its sample rate and the bit depth. The sample rate defines how many times per second the analog signal is measured. For example, a professional audio CD has a sample rate of 44,100 hertz. This means every second the signal is sampled approximately 44,000 times. And in general, the higher the sample rate, the better your audio quality. The bit depth, on the other hand, defines how many digital bits are used to store these measurements. And once again, the higher the bit depth, the better your audio. Just a couple of quick tips for you. If you're planning on recording an audio CD, for example, I'd suggest setting your bit depth and the sample rate to 16-bit 44:1K, because this matches the end medium. And the other thing to keep in mind is when you're recording in digital, pay attention to your levels, because if you clip, you get some very immediate and quite ugly distortion. So how do I connect my analog microphone into my computer? Every computer today ships with a sound card and it's going to have a mic input on it. But I wouldn't use this mic input because internal components such as the fan, hard drive, etc. can cause pretty audible hum and noise into your audio signal. A better choice would be to use a mixer like this, use the line outputs and go directly into the line input of your computer. Better yet, use an internal sound card with professional quality balanced XLR inputs, or use external sound cards, FireWire or USB, like the Shure X2U, plug it directly into the back of your microphone. The USB connector allows you to plug it directly into your computer without the need for any drivers. Specifically designed for home recording and podcasting, some microphones have a digital output. This allows you to connect the microphone directly to the computer via USB. Think about the environment you're in, whether it's a rehearsal room, basement studio, or even a hotel room. These places aren't going to be acoustically treated, and they're going to be reverberants. You'll also get other noise, such as your computer. So a couple tips for you. Close the curtains, have some thick carpets, or you can even use spare sheets and throw these into the corners. All of this is going to help dampen some of that reverberation. And lastly, make sure the microphone is close to your mouth or any other sound source. Monitoring. Listening to your mix while recording. It may not be the best idea to use traditional loudspeakers because too much sound will go from your loudspeakers into your microphone. A better option would be to use headphones. There's two types of headphones out there, closed back and open back. Once again, using open back headphones might not be ideal because too much sound may go from your headphones into your microphone. So I would suggest using closed back headphones, or better yet, for maximum isolation, use in-ear monitors. When you convert an analog signal into digital, you introduce latency. Latency is a delay in the signal path that's caused by this conversion. Most traditional sound cards will have latency of 200 milliseconds or more, which is what I'm simulating at the moment. Whereas a professional sound card would only have about 4 to 5 milliseconds of latency, which is ideal for multi-track recording. On the other hand, you could use an external sound card, such as the Shure X2U, use the headphone monitor output and monitor before the signal is digitized, and you get zero latency. The better your initial recording, the less you're going to have to do with it later. So take your time, play with your microphone selection, as well as placement in the room, and lastly, make sure you have fun.